With me in the studio today, I've got Chris Pullen from Staffline. Chris, great to see you.
Good morning.
Just to get us going, Chris, if you would, tell us a bit about the business here.
So we've got two main elements to our business. One is a recruitment business, and the other one is called PeoplePlus. So in the recruitment business, we are the UK's market-leading blue-collar industrial agency. So every day, we deploy around 60,000 temporary workers into industry.
Right.
So mainly focused in food production, e-retail, distribution, and we're also the UK's biggest HGV driver agency, supplying some of the country's biggest supermarkets and brands in that sector. In PeoplePlus, we hold another number of government contracts. So for example, we're the government's biggest provider of the work program. So when people have been unemployed for 12 months, going to the job centre, they then get referred to the work programme. We work with those customers, give them the skills they need to get jobs, and when they get into work, we receive a payment from the government. The second area in PeoplePlus is some work with the Ministry of Justice. So we provide training in prisons, and we're doing that in 10% of the country's prisons.
Mm-hmm.
We also operate a probation service in the Midlands. And then thirdly, we've got a fast-growing skills and training business whereby we give people the skills and the training they need to advance themselves into work and really addressing the government skills gap. So we're delivering the apprenticeship levy on behalf of lots of our customers, and that's a real area of growth for us in PeoplePlus.
I suppose the nature of the recruitment arm of the business here, have you experienced any negative impacts from Brexit at all?
So far we haven't experienced any negative impacts from Brexit, but it's true to say that we've got quite a tight labour market. So we've got record low unemployment, the lowest unemployment for 40 years.
Mm-hmm.
There are some uncertainties surrounded by Brexit that affect the labour market. But from our perspective, that's a real opportunity. So we are very much the agency of choice, and our workers like working for us. And actually a tight labour market is good for us because it allows us to flourish and further grow our business.
Where PeoplePlus is concerned, you mentioned the work programme there. Is that that's coming to an end?
So the work programme is in its final couple of years.
Right.
And we're transitioning the PeoplePlus business from being relatively heavy in the work programme to being more focused on the skills and training business. So it's very complementary because, of course, mm-hmm. in PeoplePlus, the work program is all about giving people the skills and the training to get into work, but actually we see a great opportunity to become the preeminent skills and training business in the UK through this transition.
And a great opportunity too for improved worker engagement. You've launched a new initiative just earlier this year.
Indeed we did. So at the beginning of the year we launched a new strategy around worker engagement in our recruitment business. So every day we deploy around 60,000 workers into industry. That makes us one of the biggest workforces in the country. And of course, engagement's extremely important. So better engaged workers we know are more productive for our customers and also stay with us for longer. And we want to become absolutely the destination of choice for our workers. So we've launched a major initiative on that, supported by a very sophisticated world-leading technology platform. So we're excited about that, and that's going to really differentiate ourselves in the future.
Well, tell me a bit more about that, because so this is all tied into this new digital platform that you've launched, is it?
Indeed it is, yeah. So the digital platform has a number of aspects. So firstly, we've made it a lot easier for people to find us. So we've relaunched our frontline engagement platform. So
right.
The idea is that if you search for a blue-collar industrial job in this country, you will come to Staffline. So the process is much more simple to go through. It's automated to get the candidates through the process much more quickly using things like artificial intelligence and chatbots in multi-languages, recognizing that quite a few of our workers come from the EU and will have different languages. And then much better search optimized for natural search. So we're getting people in much more efficiently, candidates much more efficiently in through the front end. And then we're looking to better engage with our workers to retain them better. And we're doing that through a world-leading digital platform that Fortune 500 companies use for their customer experience feedback. But we're actually deploying that to a large workforce. And we're right. the first organisation to have used that sort of technology for a significant large blue-collar workforce. And it's all about getting in-the-moment feedback from our workers and being able to take their sentiment and adjust how we manage our workforce according to the sentiment coming back from our workers, perhaps some niggles, things that might not be quite right, mm-hmm. And then to really make sure that the experience that our workers are having working for us and our customers is the best it can possibly be.
And you have had some good feedback on this?
We've had some fantastic feedback. So we trialled the approach before we launched the platform, and we know that it's going to have a really decent impact on worker engagement and productivity.
Well, we've talked a lot about the business, but you yourself, new to the chief executive role, taking over in January?
Yes, indeed. Although I joined Staffline exactly. 2.5 years ago, and I joined as chief financial officer, so that was a great way to get under the skin of the business and to really learn the nitty-gritty, working side by side with my predecessor. So we worked very closely, had a very smooth transition, and it's been a good process and a good 6 months.
And as far as the year ahead is concerned and growth, you've got your eye out for acquisitions?
So bolt-on acquisitions has always been a characteristic of our recruitment business in particular, and we'll continue with that strategy. So we'll be looking for suitable and appropriate bolt-on acquisitions where we can add a number of customer contracts to our existing business and probably take some benefits of back office synergies. Essentially what we're looking for are acquisitions in the same vertical, so blue collar industrial, where the acquired company will fill in perhaps a piece of geography where we haven't got a good presence. So a good example of that is an acquisition we made earlier on in this year called Vital, mm-hmm. A very strong, very well-performing business in the east of England, where our presence was relatively weak. So that acquisition has filled in that part of the geography, but at the same time, we're able to realise some fairly good synergies from integration. So in our hands, the business will do even better.
Just lastly, Chris, I suppose, why do you reckon people watching this, potential investors, should take a look at Staffline?
So we've got a great growth strategy ahead of us, and we think that we are clearly differentiated from our competitors, particularly through the customer experience and worker experience strategy that I've just been outlining. Mm-hmm. So, you know, whilst we've got a tight labour market and perhaps some uncertainty around the future final settlement of Brexit, that's a real catalyst for us and a real opportunity to grow whilst those conditions prevail.
Chris, really good to see you. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much.